Chemical combination. Atoms and ions. We already know that the number of all known elements is 112. 92 of these are natural elements, and the other 20 are prepared through special industrial methods. These elements are classified on the basis of their different properties and electronic structure as follows. The elements are divided into metals, nonmetals, noble gases. Now let's have an idea about the properties of these elements. First, metals. Properties of metals. Number 1. They are all solids except for mercury, which is the only liquid element of all metals. Number 2. They have luster. Number 3. Metals are good heat and electricity conductors. Number 4. They are all malleable and ductile. Number 5. Their atoms contain 1, 2, or 3 electrons in their outermost energy shells. Choose true or false. Nonmetals are good heat and electricity conductors. Well done, it's false. Now let's talk about the behavior of the atoms of metals during chemical reactions. During a chemical reaction, atoms of metals are likely to lose electrons in their outermost shells to atoms of other elements, till their outermost shells are filled with electrons. As a result, the metallic atom turns into a positive ion with a number of positive protons greater than the number of negative electrons, by a number equal to the number of electrons the atom lost. But what is meant by a positive ion? A positive ion is an atom of a metal element that loses one or more electrons during a chemical reaction. As a result, the positive ion has a number of positive charges equal to that of the electrons lost. Choose the correct answer. When an atom loses one of the electrons in its outermost energy shell, it becomes a negative ion, a positive ion, electrically neutral, or a particle. Excellent! It becomes a positive ion. Examples. A. Behavior of sodium atom, Na11-23, during a chemical reaction. In its normal condition, the sodium atom is electrically neutral, since the number of its electrons is 11, which is equal to the number of protons, and the number of neutrons in it is 12. The first shell of the sodium atom, K, contains 2 electrons, while the second shell, L, contains 8 electrons, and the third shell, M, contains 1 electron. When the sodium atom loses the single electron in its outermost energy shell, it becomes positively charged. Thus, the electrically neutral sodium atom turns into a positive sodium ion. The electronic configuration of the sodium ion will be as follows. The first shell K contains 2 electrons. The second shell L contains 8 electrons. Thus, the outermost energy shell is filled with electrons, which means that the ion is in a stable condition. The number of electrons thus becomes 10 electrons. The number of protons remains 11 protons, while the number of neutrons remain 12. In this example, we notice that the sodium Na atom loses the only single electron in its outermost energy shell during a chemical reaction. So it turns into a positive ion, Na positive, with a single positive charge due to the loss of this single electron. Observation: the number of energy shells in a positive ion is less than the number of energy shells in its atom. Properties of nonmetals. Number 1. They are elements that exist either in a solid or gaseous form, in addition to the liquid form of the bromine element. Number 2. They have no luster. Number 3. They are bad electricity and heat conductors, except for carbon, graphite, which is a good electricity conductor. Number 4. They are neither malleable nor ductile. Number 5. The outermost energy shell of their atoms contains 5, 6, or 7 electrons. Choose true or false. All nonmetals are bad heat and electricity conductors. Excellent! It's false. Behavior of nonmetal atoms during chemical reactions. During a chemical reaction, nonmetal atoms are likely to acquire electrons from atoms of other elements to fill their outermost energy shells with electrons. Therefore, they change into negative ions, in which the number of negative electrons is more than that of positive protons by a number equal to the number of electrons the atom acquired. But what is meant by a negative ion? It is an atom of a non-metal element that acquires one or more electrons during a chemical reaction. Choose the correct answer. During a chemical reaction, atoms of non-metals are likely to acquire electrons, lose electrons, keep their electrons. Very good! Acquire electrons. A negative ion holds a number of negative charges equal to the number of electrons the atom acquired. Here are some examples that show the behavior of nonmetallic atoms during chemical reactions. A. Behavior of the chlorine atom Cl1735 during a chemical reaction. In normal conditions, the chlorine atom is electrically neutral. The number of its electrons is 17, the number of protons is 17, and the number of neutrons is 18 neutrons. The electronic configuration is as follows. That the first shell K holds 2 electrons, the second shell L holds 8 electrons, while the third shell M holds 7 electrons. We notice that the chlorine atom has 7 electrons in its outermost energy shell, which means that it is a non-metal atom. During a chemical reaction, the chlorine atom Cl acquires 1 electron, which it adds to its outermost energy shell. In this way, it changes into a negative ion Cl-1, which holds a single negative charge due to the acquisition of 1 electron. Observation: the number of energy shells in a negative ion is equal to the number of energy shells in its atom. B. Behavior of the oxygen atom O8-16 during a chemical reaction. When we analyze the oxygen atom, we find that the number of electrons in it is 8 electrons. The number of protons is 8, and the number of neutrons is also 8. The electronic configuration is as follows. The first shell K holds 2 electrons, and the second shell L holds 6 electrons. During a chemical reaction, the oxygen atom acquires 2 electrons, which it adds to its outermost energy shell. In this way, it changes into a negative ion, O2-, with 2 negative charges. Exercise. Write the electronic configuration of the nitrogen atom, N714, then infer the following. Number 1, the type of element. Number 2, the electronic configuration of its ion. In normal conditions, the nitrogen atom N is electrically neutral. The number of electrons in it is 7 electrons. The number of protons is 7, and the number of neutrons is also 7. The electronic configuration is as follows. The first shell K holds 2 electrons, and the second shell L holds 5. During a chemical reaction, the nitrogen atom N acquires 3 electrons, which it adds to its outermost energy shell, thus changing it into a negative ion, N negative 3, with 3 negative charges. The electronic configuration of the nitrogen ion is as follows. The first shell K holds 2 electrons, and the second shell L holds 8 electrons. The type of atom here is that of a non-metallic element. Thus we can define the ion as an atom that loses or acquires one or more electrons during a chemical reaction. Chemical bonds. With the exception of those of noble gases, atoms of different elements combine with each other to form molecules through a process known as chemical bonding. We will study two types of chemical bonds. Number one, the ionic bond. Number two, the covalent bond. The ionic bond. An ionic bond results from the combination of a positive ion of a metallic element with a negative ion of a non-metallic element to form the molecule of an ionic compound. How is an ionic bond formed? To know how an ionic bond is formed, let's do the following activity. Study the following chart that describes the formation of sodium chloride compound, NaCl, and magnesium oxide compound, MgO. Number 1. The ionic bonding between the sodium atom, Na11, and the chlorine atom, Cl17. To form sodium chloride molecule, which is table salt, NaCl. The electronic configuration of the sodium atom is such that the first shell K holds 2 electrons, the second shell L holds 8 electrons, while the third one, M, holds 1 electron. The electronic configuration of the chlorine atom is such that the first shell K holds 2 electrons, the second shell L holds 8 electrons, while the third one, M, holds 7 electrons. In this chemical reaction, the sodium atom, Na11, loses their 1 electron in its outermost electron shell, changing into a positive sodium ion, Na positive. As a result, its outermost energy shell becomes filled with electrons. As for the chlorine atom, Cl17, it acquires the electron lost by the sodium atom and adds it to its outermost energy shell. In this way, it changes into a negative chlorine ion, Cl negative, and its outermost energy shell becomes filled with electrons. An ionic bond is formed between the positive sodium ion and the negative chlorine ion due to the electric attraction between both of them, so that, in the end, the molecule of sodium chloride compound, NaCl, is formed. Choose the correct answer. To change into a positive ion, the sodium atom loses 1 single electron, 2 electrons, or 3 electrons. Well done, it loses 1 electron. Let's have another question. Choose true or false. A covalent bond is formed between the sodium ion and the chlorine ion. Well done, it's false. Number 2. The ionic bonding between the magnesium atom, Mg12, and the oxygen atom, O8, to form the molecule of the magnesium oxide compound, MgO. The magnesium atom, Mg12, loses the 2 electrons in its outermost energy shell, changing into a positive magnesium ion, Mg12 2 positive. As a result, its outermost energy shell becomes filled with electrons. As for the oxygen atom, O8, it acquires the two electrons lost by the magnesium atom and adds them to its outermost energy shell. In this way, it changes into a negative oxygen ion, O2 negative, so that its outermost energy shell becomes filled with electrons. An ionic bond is formed between the positive magnesium ion and the negative oxygen ion, due to the electric attraction between both of them, so that in the end, the molecule of the magnesium oxide compound, MgO, is formed. It becomes clear from the above examples that the ionic bond results in forming molecules of chemical compounds only since it is formed by the combination of an atom of a metal element losing one or more electrons and an atom of a non-metal element acquiring these electrons. In other words, it is formed between different atoms. Choose the correct answer. An ionic bond is formed between the atoms of a metallic and a non-metallic element, two metallic elements, two non-metallic elements. Excellent! Between a metallic and a non-metallic element. Therefore, we can define an ionic bond as a bond that results from the force of electric attraction between a positive ion of a metal and a negative ion of a non-metal. But we must bear in mind that this is an imaginary bond that has no concrete existence. Choose true or false. An ionic bond is formed between two negative ions. Well done! It's false.